Damian Birkel from Professionals in Transition is here today. We are going to talk about some of the myths about changing your career. But first, you're pretty in pink today. What's that all about?
Breast Cancer Awareness Month is October. I just wanted to thank you and everybody here at WXII. You have been so supportive over the past 2 years as my wife fought breast cancer, and I just appreciate it.
Awesome. Way to go, Donna, and of course, we're supporting you. All right, let's get to these myths. The only way to find a job is through the internet.
No.
No, huh?
7% of all jobs come from the internet. The other 13% come from the visible job market.
People get hired because they're the most qualified.
No.
We're tearing them down.
Yeah, tearing them down. Nope. That doesn't necessarily, that's a myth.
Okay, is it harder to find a job if you're over age 40?
Some people think so. What I tell people is stand tall, be proud, sell your strengths, not your weaknesses, and if you think age is going to be an issue, it will be. If you don't, then it won't.
All right, you have to be aggressive to get ahead.
Ooh, you can maybe in the beginning, but that can be a real career buster. Because of the fact that if you bull your way through everything, eventually you're going to come up against a wall.
All right. A resume must be a complete chronological record of every job you ever had.
No. Now, I'm not saying drop jobs off to make you look younger. What I'm saying is that the deeper in your career you go, as you put it on your resume, it's perfectly appropriate to summarize.
All right. If the resume is well written, its appearance is immaterial.
Oh, no. These days, you're competing with thousands of people on paper. A crappy looking resume is kind of like wearing flip-flops and shorts to an interview. You want to have it done and look and be professional, have a career summary, all very important.
All right. Most human resource managers spend a lot of time looking at your resume.
No. 30 seconds if you're lucky. Really, if they read what you can see on the first screen, your career summary becomes vitally important because if they can't read it, and in the first 30 seconds, they'll go on to the next person.
And the final myth, the purpose of the first interview is to land that job.
No. I tell people, establish rapport, demonstrate your ability, and remember that really the only goal of a first interview
is to get a second interview,
yes,
right?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. What's the phone number to call for more information?
Area code 336-757-1099.
Awesome. Thank you so much.